Hi, I'm Dr. Mark King. I'm an infectious disease specialist at the Beacon Center for Infectious Disease at Boulder Community Health. Today we are going to talk about influenza, commonly referred to as the flu. Influenza is a common contagious respiratory illness that is caused by viruses that infect the nose, throat, and lungs. Its symptoms can range from mild to severe and can include runny nose, cough, sore throat, and fever. In some cases, influenza and its complications can be fatal. Every year, influenza outbreaks occur throughout the world. In the United States, influenza season occurs between November and March. Flu seasons are unpredictable, and the number of cases and severity of disease varies from year to year. There are about 3 to 5 million cases of severe illness reported worldwide each year. About 5 to 20% of the U.S. population gets the flu each year, with more than 200,000 people requiring hospitalization from flu-related complications. In 2014, 3,400 flu-related hospitalizations occurred in Colorado. Most people recover from the flu on their own. However, deaths or serious complications, such as pneumonia, do occur. Worldwide, it is estimated that 250,000 to 500,000 influenza-associated deaths occur each year. Anyone can get influenza. Certain groups are at higher risk for severe disease or complications. This includes children under age 2, adults over 65, pregnant women, and people with underlying medical conditions or weakened immune systems. Influenza is spread through droplets that occur when a person with influenza coughs, sneezes, or talks. These droplets can land in the mouths or noses of people who are nearby. A person might also get flu by touching a surface or object that has flu virus on it and then touching their own mouth, eyes, or nose. A person with influenza is contagious to others beginning one day before the symptoms start and for 5 to 7 days after getting sick.
Hello, I'm Dr. Todd Turner, and I'm here to talk to you about the symptoms and treatment of influenza. The most common symptoms of influenza include a sudden onset of fever, typically accompanied by headache, muscle pain, and fatigue. This is followed by respiratory symptoms such as cough, sore throat, and runny nose. In some cases, the onset of illness is so rapid that patients can identify the precise time of day that the illness began. However, influenza may also produce symptoms which are difficult to differentiate from the common cold. These include loss of appetite, discomfort, weakness, and dizziness. People may not develop a fever and respiratory symptoms. These different symptoms are more common in older adults. A person who develops influenza symptoms that do not readily resolve on their own should be evaluated by a healthcare professional. Typically, doctors can diagnose influenza based on symptoms alone. In some cases, your doctor may need to do a test to determine if your illness is due to influenza or to some other health problem. This test involves swabbing your nasal passages and then testing that sample for the presence of the influenza virus. Influenza is treated using a group of oral or inhaled drugs called neuraminidase inhibitors. This group includes drugs such as oseltamivir, known as Tamiflu, and zanamivir, known as Relenza. These drugs can reduce the duration of influenza symptoms by 1.5 to 3 days. The strongest benefit occurs when treatment is started within 48 hours of illness. There can still be benefit if started later in the disease. If your doctor prescribes you medication to take for influenza, it is important that you finish the entire course of treatment.
Hi, I'm Bev, and I'm a nurse at Boulder Community Health. And we're going to cover several ways that you can help minimize the spread of influenza.
Make sure you get vaccinated every flu season. Cough or sneeze into a tissue or your upper sleeve or elbow, not your hand. That way, you're less likely to spread the influenza virus to other people or common surfaces. Wash your hands frequently with soap and water or use hand sanitizer. If you have respiratory symptoms, you should stay home.
We hope this video has given you a basic understanding of influenza. If you have further questions, you're welcome to make an appointment with one of our providers at the Beacon Center for Infectious Diseases.